In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I will welcome you to Mass today, the fifth Sunday of Lent. We're offering our Mass for the repose of the soul of Michael Horse. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. We've moved into Passiontide, that deeper reflection of the Passion of Christ on the cross, having great sorrow for our sins. We've veiled the cross, we've veiled the statues. We're waiting for the unveiling of the reality of the cross on Good Friday, when we will genuflect to Christ's real presence on the cross. As a little extra penance, I'm sorry it's a bit chilly in here today. Came in, the heating had got an error code. I've reset it. The heating is slightly just ramping up. Should be ready for the end of Mass. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord, for we have sinned against you. Show us, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. is still to come. I'm racing for the finish, for the prize to which God calls us upwards, to receive Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. At daybreak, he appeared in the temple again. And as all the people came to him, he sat down and began to teach them. The scribes and Pharisees brought a woman along who had been caught committing adultery. And making her stand there in full view of everybody, they said to Jesus, "Master, this woman was caught in the very act of committing adultery. And Moses has ordered us in the law to condemn women like this to death by stoning. What have you to say?" They asked him this as a test, looking for something to use against him. But Jesus bent down and started writing on the ground with his finger. As they persisted with their question, he looked up and said, "If there is one of you who has not sinned, let him be the first to throw a stone at her." Then he bent down and wrote on the ground again. When they heard this, they went away one by one, beginning with the eldest, until Jesus was left alone with the woman, who remained standing there. He looked up and said, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" "No one, sir," she replied. "Neither do I condemn you," said Jesus. "Go away and don't sin anymore."
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We will have 9 adult baptisms during the Easter Vigil. There's also a reception for communion and a confirmation, and they will all be confirmed as well. And they are going to hear the account of the Exodus as an illustration of what happens to the baptized. They will see how their enemy, death, is washed away. And in the 2 processions of the Easter candle, the one from the fire in the darkness and the one during the litany of the saints to the front, they will be led through the waters of their rebirth. See in our first reading how Isaiah says, "No need to recall the past, no need to think about what was done before. See, I am doing a new deed. And these 9 baptisms are a sign of a flourishing parish. They are a result of our mission to announce the gospel of the Lord. Well done. Give yourselves a pat on the back, because it's not me who's done this, it's the community. As we move forward after the COVID pandemic, we must manage, however, our desire to return to what has been called normal. We cannot simply turn the clock back to before March 2020. There is nothing more fatal than an attitude that says, but that's how we've always done it. Well, we haven't done lots of things over the past 2 years. So perhaps now we must see this as a new springtime. And indeed, Lent is a time of renewal. It's an invitation to let go of everything that anchors us down to this life. And of course, there's nothing more certain than death to weigh us down to the earth. And we spend an inordinate amount of time celebrating our own successes and our own achievements. But these are insufficient to conquer the grave. Indeed, we celebrate instead our relationship with Jesus Christ. And we're very fortunate to have him as a secondary patron in our parish by virtue of the location of our deanery secondary school. St. Richard prays we should strive to know the Lord Jesus more clearly, to love him more dearly, and to follow him more nearly day by day. His resurrection is what it is all about. Our baptism will conform us to Jesus Christ. And being made that new creation, we're endowed with the sanctifying grace that leads to righteousness. Holiness, that's our shared vocation. But it's God's initiative, it's his calling, it's his means of bringing about our salvation. And so we're also called to make Christianity the universal basis of our morality. However, something that perhaps we once took for granted in this country, our gospel values are being pushed to the margins, perhaps even in time to a new martyrdom. That's not necessarily death, but certainly a sidelining of truth and reason is being experienced, is being taken away from national debate. And you only have to read the comments on social media to see that the lines are waiting. The struggle for the truth is not new. On Good Friday, we hear how Pontius Pilate asked Jesus, "What is truth?" Those in power are challenged to govern for the common good and not for their own ends or ambitions. And my dear brothers and sisters, you may not believe this, but it is heroic to be a Christian, called to speak truth to power, but at the same time recognizing and confessing our own struggles and sinfulness. Today, our Lord shows us that to dispense justice, one must first be aware of their own limitations. Any sentence should always be about rehabilitation, never about a score setting. The trial of the woman in the gospel is clearly a setup, but our Lord does not walk into the trap. His ability to see into people's hearts exposes the hypocrisy of the situation. As God, Jesus can pass a just sentence, because he is, of course, sinless. But this also gives him the right to dispense mercy in equal measure. It's not a free pass. She's told, this is the most worst, badly quoted gospel passage in the whole gospel. People forget this last bit. She's told to go and sin no more. Now perhaps we could imagine that her encounter with the Lord was so perfect, so transformative, that we can actually believe that she did sin no more. We are called, all of us, to conquer our passions. Jesus himself tells us, if you want to be a disciple of mine, you must renounce yourself. You must pick up your cross daily and follow me. Now, we're not born holy. It's forged through our cooperation with baptism and grace. That's only possible also if we keep up our prayer life and our formation in the faith. That's both scripture and tradition. And this season of Passiontide reminds us that the cross leads to the resurrection. Our life on earth should not be wasted. It is the beginning of our coming to perfection, not the end of it. For most of us, we're going to require some time in purgatory. That's going to be painful, because we will be shown those times when we did not love as perfectly as we ought to have done. Holiness requires effort. St. Paul uses the image of an athlete training for a race. And our vocation is the event in which we have been entered. And I think we'll all recognise that it's more of a marathon than a sprint. We also need a good coach, otherwise we might go off course. And the coach is Christ, the saints, especially Our Lady, and the church, even though from time to time we all get it wrong. Instead of the Nicene Creed, especially during Lent and Easter time, the baptismal symbol of the Roman Church, the Apostles' Creed, may be used. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, the Church, in the third scrutiny, calls the elect of God to deepen their resolve to hold fast to Jesus Christ and to carry out the decision to love God above all. And so we pray.
Yeah.
charity and receive in love. Lord, be with us. We ask Our Lady of the Rosary to pray for us and with us as we say, Amen.
Almighty Father, you are God of the living, not of the dead. You sent your Son to proclaim eternal life, to snatch us from the realm of death, and to lead us to the resurrection. Free the elect and your church from the death-dealing power of the evil one, so that we may bear witness to the new life found in the risen Christ. We ask this through the same Christ, our Lord. Amen. the teachings of the Christian faith. Graciously purify them by the working of this sacrifice, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The Lord be with you,
and with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Through Christ our Lord. For by your gracious gift each year, your faithful await the sacred Paschal feasts with the joy of minds made pure, so that more eagerly intent on prayer and on the works of charity, and participating in the mysteries by which they have been reborn, they may be led to the fullness of grace that you bestow on your sons and daughters. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as with our end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord.
So that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your Church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Mary Magdalene, St. Martha, St. Richard, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Richard our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children, scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at the passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with
us. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. On your step,
which all is set on upon me, miserable of this. On your step, which all is set on upon me, miserable of this. On your step, which all is set on me,
behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. Let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that we may always be counted among the members of Christ, in whose body and blood we have communion, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated just for a moment. As you remember, the first collection box is by St. Anthony's statue, of course. St. Anthony is veiled by the door going out. If you haven't had an opportunity to give any money to charity this Lent, the Diocesan Lent and Alms Scheme is available as our second collection today, and I'll distribute that to worthy charities. Immediately after the final blessing, we'll have Adoration of the Blessed Sacrament, our holy hour for our Lent, for Ukraine, for peace and harmony among the nations. I have a letter from Bishop Richards. It's not going to be an easy letter to read, and I'm afraid it's not going to be an easy letter to hear. Dear brothers and sisters, as your bishop, I am saddened to inform you that a priest of our diocese, Father Tony White, has been convicted of a non-recent serious offence against a child. I apologise sincerely for the actions of Father Tony White and recognise the hurt that has been caused to all involved in this case and the pain this offence has brought to the whole church. I hope that the sentencing of Father Tony will bring some comfort to those who have suffered, although it can never undo the harm they have experienced or the long wait for justice that they have had to endure. I ask you to pray for all those involved in this case, particularly those harmed by the actions of Father Tony. When the allegations were made, Father Tony was removed from ministry and will have no further ministry in the church. I renew the apologies previously made for the abuse suffered by anyone in the care of those ministering or working on behalf of the church. Our safeguarding team would like to assure anyone wishing to discuss or report abuse that we will listen to you, take you seriously, and consider how best we can support you. People affected by abuse in the church can also access help and support through Safe Spaces, a free national support service run independently by Victim Support, providing a confidential, personal, and safe space for anyone who has been abused through their relationship with the Catholic Church in England and Wales. Anyone wishing to contact the Diocesan Safeguarding Team or Safe Spaces can find their details on the Diocesan website. With the assurance of my prayers and with every blessing, Richard, your Bishop. Let us pray. Almighty Heavenly Father, who loves and cares for all your children, especially the smallest and most vulnerable, we entrust to you the lives of the many children and vulnerable adults who have been hurt and abused and whose trust and innocence have been destroyed. Help us to hear their cries of pain and to take responsibility for so many broken lives. We pray that within their communities and families, they may find understanding and support, so that with the help of your grace, their wounds may be healed, and they may again know peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down before the blessing. Bless, O Lord, your people, who long for the gift of your mercy, and grant that what at your prompting they desire, they may receive by your generous gift, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you, and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thank you.
It's almost 12 o'clock. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
and she conceived of the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it done unto me according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. And the word was made flesh. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ our Son was made known by the message of the angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. May the divine assistance remain with us always, and may the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. As always, just ask you please to keep your bench clean and tidy before you leave by using one of the virus wipes.